Hello, good morning, good afternoon, and good evening once again, depending on where you are listening from. It's a beautiful Tuesday afternoon, the 24th day in the month of November 2020. So I have this trending news to share with you guys. It's a breaking news, and the headline here says CNN dares federal government releases second report on Lekki shootings. So from the headline, I believe we guys already understand what I am going to give you, but let me give you the details of this news. Before then, don't forget to subscribe, turn on your bell notification so you get updated whenever we publish trending news like this to share with you guys. So amid threats of sanction from the federal government over its investigative report on the Lekki target shootings, CNN has released a second report on the incident. The Minister of Information and Culture, Lai Mohammed, remember last week, described CNN's report on the Lekki shootings as poor journalism, adding that the network deserved to be sanctioned. So, when I heard this story, many things this man said, this man is beginning to irritate a lot of Nigerians. All right? How do you expect to sanction CNN? I mean, maybe believing that CNN is like Channels Television or Arise Television, that a fine was imposed on them when they were, reporting the Endsars killing. Remember Channels TV, Arise Television, and other TV networks, they were fined, at the sum of, I think, 3 million naira each, just because they were reporting the Endsars shootings. Okay, so maybe Lai Mohammed feels CNN is more like Channels Television or Arise Television. If Donald Trump himself cannot sanction CNN, I am kind of thinking, how does he intend to do that? How does he intend to start to sanction CNN? Even CNN himself, they keep telling Donald Trump, that they are not working for them. So, if CNN were to be in Nigeria, believe me, the day that report was released, that particular day, the military would have surrounded that facility. Yes, this is what we see in Nigeria. If CNN were to be in Nigeria or a Nigerian network, and maybe he believes CNN is like more like NTA. You know, NTA, even if war is happening in Nigeria, NTA will still be showing people farming on their own network. They will not report. I'm talking about the NTA, the Nigerian Television Authority. They will still be showing how people, the way people are farming. They will be showing you farm even if war is going on in this country. So that is Lai Mohammed for you. So Mohammed also followed it up, also followed the thread with a letter addressed to the management of CNN in Atlanta, as we remember. But however, the network today, being Tuesday, did a second report with more damning footages showing soldiers shooting at the unarmed protesters on October 20th, 2020. So the fresh report also shows the Commander 1881 Division, Brigadier General Ahmed Taiwo, admitting before the judicial panel in Lagos that his men indeed took live ammunition to the target. Remember, the military already, they are contradicting themselves. And initially, they denied ever going to the Lekki target. After a lot of footages came out, they admitted that they were at the target, but they did not shoot. When more footages came out, they admitted ever shooting, but they shot at the air. I mean, does it make sense? Even if they did not really shoot at the protesters, but contradicting issues will make people to believe that everything you say is a lie. That is just the truth. So the CNN report also highlight the fact that Brigadier General Taiwo claim is at variance with the ministers who had claimed last week that the army fired blank bullet. So the fresh report also shows protesters running as soldiers opened fire at the target. So the National Broadcasting Corporation, which is overseen by the information ministers, okay, like I told you, was slammed with about, I think, 3 million naira fine on the three Nigerian television stations for daring to use some of the footages, which CNN has also used. So the federal government has been receiving flak from members of the UK and Amnesty International over the killing of protesters. Okay, so yesterday, when the UK Parliament were deliberating on this NSAS, it was more than the NSAS deliberation because they made some kind of revelation which I believe most of our fathers were not aware. Yes, like one of the members of the UK Parliament said that the former head of state Yakubu Gowon took half of the Central Bank of Nigeria, okay, in the 70s to the UK. Do you understand what it means, somebody taking half of the central bank, taking half of the money in central bank to the UK? So they were deliberating on it. They already know what Nigeria has gotten into, all right? So this, I would have given you this footage, okay? I'm gonna put the link, okay? I'm gonna put that link on the description for you. It is too graphic, so I really cannot share it here with you. They are too graphic. So I quickly wanted to give you guys the update that CNN has released another daring footage and report over the Lekki target shooting. So for you to know, they are standing by their report. They are standing by their own investigation. This is not Nigeria. If the CNN cannot be touched by the US president, is it the Nigerian information minister that will go and sanction CNN? Who will you report CNN to? How do you want to sanction CNN? To censor CNN in Nigeria? Does it really make sense? Because everybody is talking about, all of them, they are talking about social media regulation. So does he really intend to sanction CNN by regulating CNN in Nigeria? I really don't think that makes sense. All right, guys, so let me know what you think on the comment section below. I will see you in another video.